presentation of New York Mets baseball on the WB 11.
The New York Mets are on the air, and tonight the Subway Series has changed locations. This weekend, the Yankees have come to Shea for the first of three after the Mets lost 2 of 3 last weekend in the Bronx. The mound matchup is Steve Trachsel against Mike Mussina. It was an opportunity before the game for A-Rod to meet the Mets leadoff man Jose Reyes. Derek Jeter is here. He's in the lineup tonight. The men and women of the press corps, well, for them, the matchup has lost none of its luster. A crush of media greeting the clubs a couple of hours ago. More opportunities to meet and greet. But in a few moments, the friendly air of the pregame gives way to the Mets-Yankees and Game 1 from Shea. Hi, everybody. Welcome. We've had another rain delay. It wouldn't be the Mets and Yankees without one, but we're ready for baseball shortly. Dave O'Brien along with Tom Seaver. And Tom, the Yankees come in with the best record in baseball. They're coming off a thrilling victory over the Boston Red Sox in 13 innings last night. The Mets went to Cincinnati and took 2 out of 3 and hit 4 home runs, pulling out the win yesterday. Those victories by the New York clubs really microcosms of the way they've been winning games lately. Lots of home runs by the Mets the last several games, and for the Yankees, a ton of come from behind wins.
Yeah, the middle of the Mets lineup has really been producing in the last 4 games. The Mets have scored 20 runs. 16 of those have come via the home run. That's a 3-run shot yesterday by Shane Spencer, and it's the middle of the lineup that is doing the damage for the New York Mets. That's certainly what you look for, the guys in the middle of the lineup. Cliff Floyd, Richard Hidalgo, those guys are producing in the middle lineup for the Mets.
The Yankees are winning games every way you can. This was a couple of nights ago. Garcia Parra of the Red Sox throwing this one into the dirt. Ortiz couldn't get to it.
And what a show they had last night. The Yankees did. And Derek Jeter, he cut his face. But back, he'll be back in the lineup tonight. And then another, yet another comeback victory for the New York Yankees at Yankee Stadium. It's a great series here at Shea tonight.
Flaherty with the game-winning hit. So the Mets and the Yankees, the last 4 games for the Mets, 16 of the 20 that they've scored have been on the home run ball. The Yankees with 31 come-from-behind wins. That is the most in the big leagues. And, of course, when the Yankees take on the Mets, they circle in red ink the name of Mike Piazza on that lineup card for the Mets. The same is true when they have to look at Derek Jeter, the way he's been killing the Mets in the Subway Series.
Yeah, Mike Piazza has had a lifetime 333 average against the New York Yankees, and he's the one guy in the lineup that can hurt you. You know, David, what are we thinking about when we just saw that Cincinnati series? The guys around Piazza are hitting. In this series, they might have to pitch to Mike Piazza. He'll get some pitches to hit out of this ballpark.
Now for Jeter, it's been the story of one big hit after another when he takes on the Mets. 2 home runs last Sunday against Trachsel. That was game 1 of the doubleheader in the Bronx.
Yeah, he started very slowly, and then, you know, since that real slow start he had, he's hitting over 400. So it's the Derek Jeter that everybody that loves baseball in New York knows all about.
Piazza hitting 312 with 16 home runs. As Tom mentioned, 330 lifetime against the New York Yankees. They're both in the lineup tonight. It's lineup stocked full of stars when we come back to Shea. At 500, 13-13. They improved from 5.5 back to 3 games off the pace. Overall at 38-39. Now the week to come after this series with the Yankees. And I realize fans from both sides have trouble getting beyond this weekend series, but the week to come is huge for the Mets. 4 games against Philadelphia and then 3 at Florida right before the All-Star break. And then following the break, 4 games with Philadelphia here at Shea, 3 more against the Marlins. So, Tom, within the next 3 weeks, And the Mets are going to see the Phillies eight times in the Marlins, six times the two teams right in front of them.
Yeah, many times as a professional athlete, you go through a season in segments, because we talked about this exact same thing prior to the series, back-to-back series of the Yankees and the Cincinnati Reds. That block of games, extremely important for the Mets to stay right at that or maybe even get above that 500 mark. And this weekend, of course, here at Shea, and really sell out. It's got to be a sellout every day for the next 3 days. With this, I mean, this is the best show on earth, for crying out loud. The home teams against each other. And then after that, as you talk about, another block of games in your own division where it's, you know, every win-loss matters. It's going to make a difference in that standing. I mean, you play out of your division, you play inter, you know, interleague, you can lose and not even lose ground. You can win and not gain ground. But now all of a sudden you're going to get back in, and then are you going to stay three games behind? Are you going to stay there? You're going to drop to six below, or are you going to go up to the top and potentially get, you know, get in the lead of the National League East? So when you're inside that division, you really can see the standings in that division jump around.
Let's get right to the starting lineup now, brought to you by your Tri-State Quality Ford store and for Joe Torre's Yankees. At the top of the order, it will be Bernie Williams, Derek Jeter at short, Gary Sheffield in right, A-Rod at third base, Hideki Matsui 0 for 5 in his career against Trachsel. Posada doing the catching with Tony Clark at first base. He's swinging a hot bat, the former Met. Miguel Cairo at second base, and Mike Mussina is pitching and batting ninth against Trachsel. Despite pitching 7 innings last Sunday, Trachsel took the loss in game 1 of that doubleheader at Yankee Stadium. He was beaten 8-1. Jeter and Sheffield jumped on him early, and it was Jose Contreras the story after that as he took over the game.
Yeah, Trachsel with 3 early home runs and then in that game over at Yankee Stadium, and that's really settled down. You see his numbers, the defense behind him here at Shea in game 1 of this 3-game series, brought to you by your local Lincoln Mercury dealers. In the outfield for the Mets, Cliff Floyd, Shane Spencer to start in center. On this beautiful evening here at Shea, Richard Hidalgo in right. The infield, Wigginton at third, Kaz Matsui at short, Jose Reyes at second. Eric Valente is the first baseman, Piazza behind the plate. And Mr. Cashman, the general manager of the New York Yankees, in attendance. Former Mayor Rudolph Giuliani in attendance. Big digs here at Shea Stadium. VIPs coming out of the woodwork.
That's right. We just saw Kevin James down there. Tim Robbins, yep. The actor, came up in the booth to say hello to you. And Whitey Herzog.
The Rat.
The Rat is here. The former St. Louis Cardinal and Kansas City Royal manager.
The Rat is here, and he's looking at somebody.
Now, Bernie Williams about to lead things off for the Yankees, then Jeter and Sheffield. The Yankees with the best record in baseball coming in. Their win over the Red Sox yesterday, which turned out to be a classic, pushed them a season-high 8.5 games in front of Boston. The Yankees, with that advantage in their division, have the largest lead of any team, any first-place team, in any division in baseball. So we're all set to go right now, 42 minutes late because of the rain delay, but as Tom mentioned, it has turned into a lovely evening all of a sudden. And not a rain cloud in sight. Williams at 268. He's homered 9 times, but hitless in his last 12 at-bats. The fans are settling in. And the first pitch of the night from the right-hander Steve Trachsel is on the way. It is high for ball one. Mike Riley makes the calls behind the plate tonight. And the Mets up on the railing, up on the top step of that dugout right away, as are most of the Yankees. Popped up behind third. Wigginton on Matsui on the run. Matsui makes the catch. Kaz Matsui charges to get it. And Bernie Williams pops out for the first out of the evening. And here comes Derek Jeter. Yesterday bloodied, battered, and hospitalized. What a mixed reaction.
Well, it's a mixed reaction, but you know what? There's some blue caps on some of those people that are standing up and applauding. Not really because you're a Yankee or you're a Met, doesn't make any difference. But they appreciate the effort and the way he goes about his business.
Lusty boos, and the folks in those blue caps you're talking about, the Yankee blue caps, a standing ovation for the Yankee captain. He's got the bandage there over the chin. Since May 26th, he has been killing everybody, a .403 average. Only Pudge Rodriguez of the Detroit Tigers has been hotter. He takes inside for ball and the count 2-0. So that brings up the question, as badly as he was bruised up and the cuts and the shoulder, that shoulder injury that he suffered, slammed it hard into a seat. Will that be enough to curtail his battering of the Mets? Fouls that one away.
2-0, let her go. Trachsel did not throw a strike for the first two pitches, and Derek Jeter gets in that spot. He'll guess fastball, as 90%, 95% of your hitters in the big leagues will do, and he'll go after it. Well, I think Trachsel does so well, he'll throw that pitch and get away with it if he gets it up above the top of the strike zone. But you're living in dangerous territory when the hitter is ahead of you on that count.
One down, bases empty in the 2-1 pitch. Down to get it, Reyes from the outfield. Grassy throws out Jeter. Two down. Jeter came into the game 368 lifetime against Trachsel with three home runs. And on the topic of home runs, Gary Sheffield hit one off of Trachsel in the first inning last weekend. And he's driven in 8 runs in his last 6 games. Sheffield probably as terrifying as any hitter this side of Barry Bonds. Let's put it this way, right-hand hitters, when he is as hot as he is right now. Overall at 300 with 13 homers. And he takes ball one. His home run last weekend on Sunday, game one of the doubleheader. That was right after Jeter had gone yard, but this one was out in about 2 seconds, Tom.
If you blink, you miss it. I mean, just a rocket line drive left center at Yankee Stadium. Oh, just missed that one.
Popped it up a mile high to left. Floyd in for it. And Trachsel off to an excellent start. He gets Williams, Jeter, and Sheffield in order on just 8 pitches. Floyd clinching the last one, and the Mets are coming up. Your Tri-State Quality Ford store. Here's the lineup. Jose Reyes, then Kaz Matsui, and Mike Piazza. Mike with 8 career home runs against the Yankees. Cliff Floyd, Richard Hidalgo, who is cooking right now. He's in right. Shane Spencer's in center. Mike Cameron out with a banged-up knee. Ty Wiggins in the third. Eric Valent will play first. Trachsel pitching, batting ninth. Mike Mussina coming in 9-4.
Outstanding right-hander, most of his years with the Baltimore Orioles, and the owner of an outstanding knuckle curveball, 2,814 lifetime in his career. This season, Mussina 9-4 with a 4.6 earned run average, and he faces Jose Reyes in the leadoff spot.
He beat the Mets last Sunday in game 2 of the doubleheader for his 8th consecutive win, although it was not without trouble. The Yankees won at 11-6. There's a strike on the inside half to Reyes, nothing to 2.
But then one of the things you do and points you make, 196 innings pitched, 113 hits he has given up. He is very stingy with his base on balls, only 21 walks during the season. How many of those have been pitching around somebody? So you can get people on. But can you get them across? That's part of the problem. Relatively high 4.6 earned run average. But you got the Yankee offense behind it, and he keeps you in the ballgame.
Well, he did give up 3 home runs to the Mets on Sunday. 5 runs total in 6 innings. 1-2 pitch foul back by Reyes. Matsui next.
That's an old theory, too. Remember the Yankees got on top 6-0, I think it was. I'm going off the top of my head. I think they went 6 runs in the first inning.
Yes.
The old theory, this is old-time baseball. Here, hit it. Hit it out of the ballpark. You can have as many solo home runs as you want. No singles and no walks, just here. If you want to hit another ballpark, and he gave up the home runs and won the ball game. And that was when you play for, you know, the old timers, the Whitey Herzogs. We've had a shot of him before. Mm-hmm. Anytime talking about Gil Hodges or any of the old time players.
Well, look at this now.
Managers, that's what they say.
There's a chip on the end of that bat. Posada pointed it out to the home plate umpire Mike Riley, then asked for time. Take a look at Reyes' bat. There's a big hunk out of it.
I don't blame Jorge Zapata. Posada, I don't blame him one bit. I mean, that's a safety measure right there. If something gets chipped off, somebody could, you know, something could land in his eye. That's more just a safety measure more than anything else.
The 1-2 pitch. Swing, fly ball, lifted into right. Sheffield there to make the catch. So one man out, and that'll send up Kaz Matsui.
Let's take a look at our defense here for the Yankees, brought to you by your Lincoln Mercury dealers. In the outfield, Matsui, Bernie Williams, and Gary Sheffield left to right. The infield, Alex Rodriguez and Jeter, all stars on that left side. Miguel Cairo, Tony Clark to start at first base. Jorge Posada does the catch.
Casual Matsui at 250 with five homers. He's driven in 25 runs. Mets, by the way, have not scored a first inning run in their last 14 games. And that is the longest streak by a Met team in 2 years. Not scoring early, although taking two out of three from Cincinnati. Jeter down on the backhand, steadies, throws, and in time. Matsui is out. Derek Jeter, despite appearances, looking just fine.
Backhand, get rid of it quickly with a man that can run. No argument from either Matsui or Gary Pettis, the first base coach. This is a fine defensive play. Stop it and get in the air and depend on the first baseman to pick it out. And I thought he was safe, and all of a sudden you get the replay, a great replay, and you see he was out at first base.
Jeter blinking a lot, that right eye. He's got the shiner there. Here's Mike Piazza, 312, 16 homers. And he takes the first pitch in there for strike. Cliff Floyd will bat if anybody continues the inning, and Mike Piazza can get a hit here. Two down. Nothing, nothing in the first. The 0-1 pitch hit toward the hole and underneath Rodriguez's glove. And Piazza is safely on at first base. We'll see how they rule on this, but it looked playable. Alex Rodriguez was brilliant in their victory over Boston. Can't make this play.
Well, they misjudged the overspin. My ball right there is going to hit that boom and take off. See it take off? Alex Rodriguez thought he was going to get another side. Nice soft little hop. He did not. And that ball seemed to accelerate right by him. That's, you know, going through that learning curve of playing third base.
Well, he's been terrific there. Of course, he won the Gold Glove at shortstop each of the past two seasons, but he has the second highest fielding percentage among American League third basemen this year. Didn't get to that one. It's ruled a base hit.
It was so good they gave him two bases. Let's have two hits on the board.
Two up in the hit column. Wow, that was impressive. Fouled away by
Cliff. They really liked that base hit. That was so good, we'll give him two.
Yeah. Richard Hidalgo up next. Yeah, under the hit column on the scoreboard. That's worth two hits.
He's gonna be hitting 400 before the year's out.
You thought Bianchi was a good hitter before? Now they've taken one away. The 0-1 pitch smacked into left on the line, backing up Matsui. Reaches up and drops it. Here comes Piazza, heading for third. He's being waved around. Jeter will not throw it, and the run is in. The Mets grab a 1-0 lead on some shaky Yankee defense here in the bottom of the first inning. Hideki Matsui could not handle that searing line drive on the warning track.
Ball hit like a bullet by Cliff Floyd to left field. He had the ball. That ball's got to be played. Not playing in Yankee Stadium. Trying to get adjusted to Shea Stadium. You're not sure exactly where that wall is. And it's got to be on the left field. And also, I think Derek Jeter had a shot at Mike Piazza at home plate.
Did not uncork the throw.
Did not uncork. And he forgot who was running. And he clearly had a play at your home plate. His shoulder, as you pointed out, David, could be bothering him.
Ruled an error on Matsui, and that brings up Richard Hidalgo, hitting 263 with eight homers. A-Rod could not get the single, which in the end was ruled worth only one hit for Mike Piazza. Could not reach it. Seconds later, Matsui drops one. 1-0, the Mets in front. Hidalgo coming off a hot series against Cincinnati. Takes a swing for the fences and fouls it away.
Hideki Matsui in left field, a little tentative. Take his eye off that ball. He was searching for the wall out of the corner of his eye on the other side. And just by a fraction, you take it off for that nanosecond. And the ball did not get into the web of the glove. It's the old hometown and home field advantage.
Hidalgo homered twice against Mussina last weekend. Fly ball right center field. Hard run, Bernie Williams. He slides. He cannot get it. Floyd is in. Hidalgo's into second, standing up. It is 2-0 the Mets. Bernie Williams sliding deep into the alley, but he came up empty on it. RBI number 38 for Hidalgo. His bat's really come alive.
He almost got there, but short hopped it, did not hold on to the ball. That'll be a double for Hidalgo. And 38th RBI. This at normal speed, a long run for Bernie Williams. Gary Sheffield pulled off. That ball just seemed to go away from him and away from him. The flags in center field are absolutely dead. And it was just sliced away from him. That's the way it came off the bat. Well, the Mets, who were hot with a bat in Cincinnati, pick it up right here on the first inning against New York.
That brings up Shane Spencer wailing away on the first pitch and fouling it back. He's hitting right at 300. The former Yankee. He whacked a three-run homer yesterday. Cliff Floyd coming in. Remember, he reached on the Matsui drop ball in left field. So the Mets in front 2-0. Hidalgo leading at second. And that's on the outside corner for strike. Shane Spencer in pinstripes between 1998 and 2002. The first inning has been a black hole for Mike Mussina. Look at that ERA of 7.88. And for the first time in 15 games, the New York Mets have scored in the first inning. Check swing, didn't mean to. Cairo with it, bends him down, and the side is retired. But a very productive inning for the Mets, a sloppy inning for the Yankees. And the Mets lead it 2-0 after one at Shea. The accounts and descriptions of this game may not be disseminated without the express written consent of Sterling Metz. A little wriggle room here for Steve Trachsel. It is 2-0, the Mets in front of A-Rod's Yankees. We had a 42-minute rain delay tonight. And then when it started, the Yankees started raining some defensive mistakes. A-Rod could not get to a ground ball that probably he should have made a play on. Granted, a sharp chopper by Mike Johnson, and Hideki Matsui dropping a line drive in left field on the warning track to keep the inning alive. Derek Jeter also balked at throwing on the relay to home with Mike Piazza trying to score. Looked like he had a chance at him. He elected not to, maybe because of the sore shoulder. 1-0 pitch, a fastball right through the chute on A-Rod, who's hitting 283 with 19 homers. He found himself at shortstop at the end of yesterday's win over the Red Sox. Shifted from third base after Derek Jeter flew into the stands and was banged up in the 12th inning. A-Rod called that 13-inning drama with Boston. He said, "It's the greatest game I've ever watched, played, or been in the ballpark for. It was an unbelievable war." They go right from that to playing the Mets.
And Gary Sheffield at third base. Mm-hmm. Came in from the outfield. Sheffield signed as a third baseman.
The first time since 1993.
Take a look at the last pitch. Clearly off the plate.
Third baseman Gary Sheffield back in right tonight for the Yankees.
Huge loss for the Atlanta Braves and a huge gain for the Yankees.
3-2 now on Rodriguez. Hideki Matsui next, and then Jorge Posada for Torrey's team. We talk about it all season long. Trachsel is two different pitchers. He's one pitcher here at Shea Stadium. He's another guy on the road, as he showed in the Bronx last weekend. But here at Shea, a 176 ERA. It's the second best home earned run average in the National League. Little dribbler. Trachsel handles this one. One down. He set down the first four Yankees. Let's get a look at that pitch location.
Pitching coaches will talk about, well, it's real estate. Location, location, location. And that's a movement and change of speed. And Rodriguez way out in front. So he's way out in front. His weight is off. Balance is off. He got it in the right spot. Changed speeds. It disrupted the hitter. And Rodriguez way out in front. Rick Peterson, the pitching coach, you saw there. And he, of course, has seen these American League hitters a lot. That is an advantage for his pitching staff.
One man out. Here's Hideki Matsui at 280. He's hit 15 home runs. And he takes outside ball one. 0 for 5 in his career against Trachsel. The Yankees trying to win their sixth in a row, but they're in a quick hole here. The Mets on top 2-0. Big swing and a miss by Godzilla. One ball and one strike. And of course, with the stars from Japan, both named Matsui, playing again here on a Friday night in New York City. The game is being beamed back to Japan, where it's morning. And they're expecting big audiences to tune in the land of the rising sun. That's in there for a strike, 1-2. You and I talking to some of the Japanese broadcasters before the game. Absolutely thrilled here in New York. The series in the Bronx and here at Shea. Softly rolled the first, but a foul ball.
You know, we were chatting with some of those news reporters from Japan, some that I knew from the two trips that I made to Japan over there, one with the Cincinnati Reds, one certainly with the New York Mets. I think it was back in 1974. There's some of the members of the press corps from the Far East.
In fact, that's the makeshift television booth. You know, the Japanese newspapers will be loaded with photos of both Matsui's tomorrow morning. The 1-2 pitch up high. Posada up next. He made an interesting point about when Posada in the first inning with Reyes batting had a chip on the end of that bat, and he asked the home plate umpire Mike Riley to get Jose to throw that bat out. He did, and he got a new one. He wound up flying out to right field. Down 3-2 now on Matsui. But that's a defective bat. That's interesting to me that Posada, knowing that an opponent was swinging a defective bat, would want that bat thrown out instead of keeping it.
He doesn't want a splinter in his eyes.
I understand that. That's in there for strike three. Trachsel strikes out Hideki Matsui. He catches him looking, and there are two down.
3-2, good pitch by Trachsel. You decide right on that corner. Hideki Matsui looking inside. That's not even dead on the corner. That had a good piece of the plate. The hitter will tell you what he was doing. He's looking either for the splitter. You see his rear end seems to be gone there. He's looking middle end. Didn't get it. Trachsel got it on the outer half of the plate. And when you get a hitter looking on one side of the plate, not defending the plate, which a hitter like that should do. You get their balance going the wrong way, and that pitch on that outside part of the plate, not corner part of the plate, becomes a perfect pitch.
Giambi out of the lineup yet again because of intestinal parasites. In fact, the same thing that has afflicted Kevin Brown, the Yankee pitcher, who's also been troubled by a bad back. But intestinal parasites are not contagious. So this is a great mystery, also very rare in places like the United States. So Giambi thought at first maybe Japan was where he might have contracted that, but most of the doctors say that is not the case. Fouled away by Posada. It's not something you can spread around a clubhouse, you know, by touching the same utensils or whatnot. So it's quite a mystery. But Gary Sheffield actually was examined for the same thing because he's had stomach problems, gastrointestinal problems, and they thought maybe that was part of Sheffield's difficulty. He was ruled out. Line shot to base hit, scalded the other way over Matsui. A clean hit for Posada, just the third he's had in 16 at-bats against Steve Trachsel.
Going the other way, looking the other way, going that way. Posada came in and hit 269, turning right-handed. He's hitting over 300, just 244 left-handed, but a good swing there going the other way. Pretty good hot bat right now for the New York Yankees and the ex-Met Tony Clark.
Well, hit a two-run homer and was 1-for-5 in Thursday's win against Boston. And Tuesday against Boston, hit his fifth home run of the season, so he now has six. Tony had some meaningful hits for the Mets last year, coming off the bench in particular, late in games. As he takes the fastball and it's in there for strike. Overall hitting just 219. Posada on at first. It is 2-0 the Mets after an inning, and now into the second inning. And Trachsel has been very sharp on a mound. He's been very hard to hit all season long. Mike Piazza behind the plate tonight, and the 0-1. Right where he wanted it. That's exactly where Piazza set up, and it's 0-2.
Steve Trachsel very comfortable on this mound at Shea Stadium. His control has been impeccable so far. Does it hit that outside corner? Oh, perfectly. Just by a whisper.
Number 41 and number 31. Big time Mets fans from different eras. Tim Ramos came into the booth, and he was a big, big Tom Seaver fan growing up. Had a lot of kind things to say about number 41.
Said he was here in 69 up in the upper deck in the 11th row from the top, or whatever it was, when we either won the pennant or division or World Series, whatever it was. You know, one of the great shots in our opening, that crack crew that we have in the truck down there, was that, oh, the crack crew, you said, yeah. Was the shots they had the kids outside Shea Stadium? One in a Mets shirt, one in a Yankee shirt. Dad brings the kids. Ernie Robbins, same way. One of the kids had a Mets shirt, one of them had a Yankee shirt on.
Swing and a miss. Clark down on strikes, and Trachsel strikes out two in the second inning. He gives up one hit and strands Posada at first base. After an inning and a half here at Shea, it is 2-0 the Mets. The quote book for the night. This is Tom Glavine, who will not pitch in the series. Art Howe's decision. Tommy saying no decision ever seems to be an easy one. The fact of the matter is we're trying to win our division. Our season is not going to be made or broken by what we do against the Yankees. It's Tom Glavine.
Well, Art Howe has talked about what he thinks about interleague play. And, you know, what we talked about, David, too, inside your division, those are the games you really want to win. I mean, they, from a standing standpoint, where you rank in the standings in your own division, the games coming up after Sunday are much more important than these games. These are great games for the fans. They're great games for baseball. They're terrific for baseball.
Why is that one to straightaway? One up and one down.
But when you start playing Philadelphia, Florida, and the Atlanta Braves, then that's, you know, the ante, you know, what you have to ante up is double.
You know, starting on beginning of next week, basically what the Mets play exclusively is the Florida Marlins and the Philadelphia Phillies. That's it for a couple of weeks before and after the break.
Atlanta gets in the mix in there. They're right before the, I think it's the 23rd of July, that weekend.
Eric Glenn hitting .264, five homers. He's driven in 17 runs. One down, bases clean, and Mussina delivers a strike. A look at the upcoming schedule brought to you by Honda. That's Ginter and So, the next couple here against the Yankees, against Contreras and Vasquez. And then at Philadelphia for four, followed by three against the Marlins in South Florida right before the All-Star break. And right after the break, four against the Phillies here, as well as three against the Marlins here. So that's a lot of baseball against the two teams right in front of the Mets right after this series. Steve Trachsel up next. Valent talking about Mike Mussina before the game and how, as he stings a single to right field, he fully expected to see an array of those knuckle curveballs. And he said he paints the black edge of the plate as well as anybody he has seen.
He got that knuckleball and read it. He was looking almost like Valent was looking for it and went out and got it, pulled it, rolled that top hand over and pulled it in the hole between first and second. That ball was on the outer half. Instead of trying to hit that ball to left center, he rolled that top hand over and got himself a single. Gives you a situation where you can use your pitcher. That number 8 hole is so important. from the offensive standpoint, and it's so important from the pitcher's standpoint to negate it, because now Trachsel could bunt and utilize the sacrifice and get a runner to scoring position for the top of the lineup. It's so important. And everybody forgets about it. Well, this is the number eight hitter. It can't be a real good hitter. This is not, it's not a big deal. It's a huge deal in the context of how you go through the lineup, where your outs are, who leads off the following inning.
Trachsel has dropped down two sacrifice bunts so far this season. Hoping this will be number three. Mussina, an outstanding fielder, throws over to get him, gets the certain out. Valent into scoring position, and they're two away. Jose Reyes will try and pick up this RBI now. Jose in the first inning flied out to right field, so he is 0-1. Yesterday, he belted one of the Mets' four home runs at Great American Ballpark in Cincinnati. Also laid down a bunt single. Those hits followed an 0-for-18 skid. This side of the plate has not been kind to Jose since he came back from the hamstring and back problems. Hitting left-handed, he is just 4-for-42. Outside for ball one. Now, Tom, how long is it going to take him to feel comfortable? How long is it going to take Jose Reyes to swing the bat as he did in July and August last year?
Well, that's a question everybody's asking. Nobody really can have the answer. I don't think Jose knows. I mean, you get people who say, well, he's got to get a nice play at second. Well, they get Reyes.
No, he's safe. Down to third moves Valent. Reyes beat it out. Cairo trying to throw from the seat of his pants.
Well, the speed of Reyes makes Cairo try to rush this play and get its balance. He lost it. Nice stretch by Tony Clark. Wow. Bang, bang at first base. Oh, wow. Maybe the Mets there got a break.
Oh, they did.
Chuck Merriweather, the umpire at first base. Take a look at that from this angle. Oh, yeah. They caught a break there. Now capitalize on it.
Yeah, it's in the glove. He has possession, and Reyes isn't there yet. He should have been out. So the inning ought to be over for the Yankees, but very little is going right for them in the early going. And the speed of Reyes on at first base with Eric Valent at third, and the Mets bidding for more already in front 2-0. Reyes on with an infield hit. Kaz Matsui 0-for-1. Is grounded to short. With a win tonight, the Mets get back to 500. They'll be 39-39. The Mets do have the best home record in the National League East. They're Chase Stadium 21-16. And with Trachsel on the mound, who always seems to pitch well at Shea. That's outside. 1-0 on Kaz Matsui. The odds are lurking. You would think Kaz Matsui would see a pitch to hit on 1-0, or if it gets to 2-0, that he would like a lot. Swinging a high fly ball into right. Jumped on it. Sheffield back to the wall. She's gone. A two-run homer for Kaz Matsui. Pardon me, a three-run homer for Kaz Matsui. His sixth home run of the season. Yeah, I would say he liked that pitch on 1-0 an awful lot, and he jumped all over it to right to make it 5-0. Well, that's the catbird seat right in front of Mike Piazza.
Well, if you get ahead in the count and Piazza in the on-deck circle, you can bet you could sit fastball. What did he get? That fastball right at the crosshairs. Where do you think it'd be on the front page of that? Those newspapers in Tokyo tomorrow morning, or tomorrow afternoon, I suppose, to be more correct from a time standpoint. Sat on fastball and got it. High fly ball to right field. That's how the presence, just the presence of a Mike Piazza can change a ball game. And you know he was looking fastball.
Piazza one for one tonight. He singled and scored in the first inning. And he takes 3-0. And of course, that play at first base, Chuck Merriweather did not get the call right, according to our replays. The inning allowed to keep on going, as Reyes was giving credit for the infield hit. And it looked like he should have been out in the end of the inning. That allowed Matsui to bat. All smiles here, 5-0 the Mets. 3 balls and a strike on Piazza. He fouls it away. Might be talking about some swirling wind up top, but you know what? There's no wind at all according to those flags. And any other flags here, Shea? 3-2 pitches outside, so Piazza is on. Ball four to Mike. So it's been a real scuffle of an inning for Mussina. He's allowed a single, another single, the three-run homer, and now the walk to Piazza. Here's Cliff Floyd. He reached on an error by Hideki Matsui in the first inning. And he came in to score on the double by Richard Hidalgo. Piazza aboard with two out. Fouled away, and a mighty cut by Floyd as he went for the downs on that swing.
That's the 20th pitch of the inning for Mike Mussina. You can look at it again. He has struggled through this inning. That's pitch number 20. Pretty good breaking ball right there. Floyd way out in front of it.
The 0-1 pitch. Hard hit. Through for a base hit. Piazza moves up 90 feet. He'll stop at second. And this long inning for Mike Mussina continues. Cliff Floyd one for two.
Four hits in the inning for the New York Mets, plus a walk, the walk to Piazza. Just out of the reach of Miguel Cairo. Mel Stottlemyre is going to come out of the dugout. That home run by Matsui, the 12th home run that Mike Mussina has given up. We talked about in the opening, Mussina came in here with 96 innings pitched in his 17 previous starts. This is his 18th start here at the stadium. And he had given up 113 hits in those 96 innings pitched. He is a control artist, but he's not a pitcher that can throw the ball by you. His best pitch is a knuckle curveball. And he has been an outstanding pitcher, over 200 career wins. And when he does locate, get the ball in the right spot, he can be tough as nails, but he has not been able to make consistent pitches that are quality pitches here tonight, and the Mets have taken advantage of it.
Well, now he's facing a guy who seems to have a pretty good read on Mike Mussina. Richard Hidalgo. Line drive base hit into left field. Hit too hard for Piazza to score. Floyd takes a big turn trying to get back to second. He's going to be tagged out. He took way too wide a turn. A base running error there by Cliff Floyd. Otherwise, the bases would have been loaded and the Mets would have been bidding for more. They do get three in the inning off the Kaz Matsui home run off of Mike Mussina. 5-0 the Mets. Tom Seaver, Dave O'Brien with you here on the WB 11. Great to have you along as we go to the third inning. 5-0 the Mets in command behind Steve Trachsel, Miguel Cairo, Mike Mussina the pitcher, and then Bernie Williams due up in the inning. Tonight a 42-minute rain delay. But unlike last Friday, we're able to play on the very night the rain falls because it's cleared up beautifully. Mr. Seaver, an old pal.
I couldn't see the number then. It was 14. It was Gil Hodges. And I don't remember what number Ron Hodges. I would presume it's Gil Hodges. Yep, it's 14. Saw Joni Hodges out here at the ballpark the other day. I believe it was two weekends ago. Looking just as lovely as forever. There's Mr. Hodges. That kind of personality, that's what you wanted to call him, too.
Mr.
He didn't do it, but you felt like you should, you know. And you, the one thing you didn't want was to have him calling you because I want to speak to you in my office. You didn't want that. That's one thing when you got to work, you didn't want to have Gil wants to see you in his office.
2-1 to Cairo, popped up right side. Valente searching for it, couldn't find it, and it's off into the crowd anyway. He had a lot of trouble with that ball because there's some darker clouds overhead, but some twilight as well.
You ready for a little Dodger quiz from Seaward O'Brien?
Sure.
What was his nickname? What was Gil Hodges' nickname? How's that, huh? That's a good one. And I don't know how in the world you'd ever pick up with
it. It was Tex.
No. He's from Princeton, Indiana, is where he was born.
Princeton, Indiana.
And lived, played and lived in Brooklyn. Raised his family in Brooklyn. Joni still lives in Brooklyn.
You're not going to give me a hint?
No, well, I could, but, you
is
know.
It a funny, sweet nickname?
No, it's just, it's
is
kind
it
of a
non, ironic nickname?
It's a non sequitur. It doesn't fit. But, you know, maybe if you were in Miami, you'd be able to figure it, but I don't know whether you'd be able to do that or not.
I have no idea.
That was a clue, in case you've got
the
kind of a deep,
that,
you know.
That's too far to go.
Yeah.
What was Gil's nickname?
How many times do I?
This isn't common knowledge.
You, I have to ask you many, many times, don't I?
I still don't get it. what's his nickname?
Mooney. Many, many moons. Moon over Miami. Come on, you should have picked him.
That's just terrible.
His nickname was Mooney. I don't know where it came from. And the old players called him Mooney. We players did not call him Mooney. If we were going to call him that, we'd have called him Mr. Mooney. But we did not do that.
So when you got hauled into the office.
No, you didn't say how you doing, Mooney.
How you doing, Mooney?
No.
Good to see you again, Mooney. Off the middle track down nicely to his left, Matsui. Throws on to get Cairo. Let's go downstairs to Kip Lewis for an update on Mike Cameron, who's out of the lineup tonight because of a banged-up knee.
Yeah, Dave, you mentioned that banged up knee, and he also added before the game that he said he's also having a problem with his groin. He said he was in a lot of pain before tonight's game. In fact, he said as of right now, he can't even run. He's hoping to play sometime this weekend, but as of right now, guys, it doesn't look too good. Dave?
Well, Mike Cameron's a guy who doesn't like to complain about injuries, although he seems to have had more than his share in the first half of the 2004 season. As Mussina, as he takes a strike. Look at the injury. This is a Great American Ballpark on Wednesday. He went diving and hitting that left knee hard into the ground. That was before the groin injury he talked about. Swung on and missed by Mussina. The count quickly 0-2. So Mike Cameron out of the lineup for the foreseeable future. Shane Spencer manning center field tonight. Cut on and fouled away right there at the plate. So Mussina hangs in there, still nothing in two. Bernie Williams up next, bases clean, one out. Trachsel trying to pick up his eighth victory shortly before the All-Star break. And the 0-2 pitch.
Piazza set up outside, ball missing. Interesting number, Mussina hitting 216, huh?
Pops it up, Matsui there. Two down.
American League hitter, American League pitcher, and has never really been able to hit in the big leagues because of the DH, and he's hitting over 200 career-wise in these interleague play games.
Now, Mike Mussina, a really, really good athlete. What has he won? 6 gold gloves?
Yep. Right in.
He was the best fielding pitcher, I believe, in the majors last year. Here's Bernie Williams, 0-4-1 tonight. He started the evening by popping out to short. He is without a hit in his last 13 at bats. Bernie out of the leadoff spot this evening, one of 6 men that Joe Torre has used in the top spot in the order this year, along with Lofton and Jeter, Crosby and Wilson, and Cairo. The Mets, by the way, have used four men so far this season as the leadoff hitter. The 0-1 pitch drifts away. One ball and one strike. This is a different looking Yankee team when you look at the faces of A-Rod and the others than the one that left the diamond after the 13 inning thriller against Boston yesterday. Good fastball in there for a strike as they trail the Mets 5-0. Gary Sheffield so far 0-1 tonight. Joe Torre had some rather pointed remarks, though, as far as the umpiring of that game yesterday. Gary Sheffield was hit not once, but twice. Once by Pedro Martinez by pitch, and the other time by Curtis Laskanik. And particularly that last one by Laskanik, Torre believed was fully intentional. No doubt in his mind, he was very, very angry with the umpiring crew. He talked with Tim McClellan afterwards, and the umpiring crew did not see it that way. They did not see it as intentional. But Torre is convinced that was the case. That Laskanik was throwing at Sheffield. Base is empty, two down, 2-2 the count on Bernie Williams. The switch hitter puts it in play, right to Reyes, an easy stop. Side retired. Another breezy inning for Steve Trachsel. He gets them 1-2-3. The Mets out in front, 5-0 here. The second round, the Mets lead it 5-0 with Shane Spencer in the box against Mike Mussina. First pitch swinging, rolls that one to A-Rod, who guns it right on target. One pitch, one out. Shane Spencer 0-2. New York Mets baseball is being brought to you tonight by your Honda dealers. Discover the great values now being offered. And by AM New York, New York's free daily newspaper. Mike Piazza being cooled off with some cold towels on the bench. As he gets the catch tonight, Mike's also been on base twice, a single and a walk. That's something that the Yankees have been trying to do to Piazza ever since interleague play started. Cool him off, but they've had very little success. His batting average against the Yankees is around 340 with 8 homers. Ty Wigginton is 0-1. He goes for the downs there and misses it. It's 0-2.
Looked like Ty Wigginton got a hanger right here. Oh, yeah, middle in. Oh, pulled off it. I don't think he can swing much harder. No contact, no home run.
Popped up. Is it catchable? Clark believes it is, and right around the coach's box, he's got it. Ty Wigginton 0-2. He's just one hit the last couple of weekends against the Yankees. And with two away, here comes Eric Valence. Eric with a single in the second inning. Then Trachsel bunted him over. Reyes reached on an infield hit. The replay showed he should have been called out at first base. Chuck Merriweather missed that call. Moments later, Kay Matsui hit a three-run homer. Little comebacker, and it's a 1-2-3 inning for Mike Mussina. That takes him just 5 pitches. Another great effort from Carlos Zambrano. He's now 9-3 beating the White Sox today. In that Boston and Atlanta game, David Ortiz with home run number 22. J.D. Drew has homered for Atlanta. He's healthy and having an outstanding year. Detroit and Colorado, it is 2-1 the Rockies in the third inning. They have rain in St. Louis. Seattle taking on the Cardinals there in the third inning. In the first of two, the Pirates 8-1 over Milwaukee. They're in the second inning of game two. And in game number one, Oliver Perez struck out 11 for the Bucks. Here's Derek Jeter, 0-1 tonight. He's grounded out to second. He's coming off a big, big month of June. He hit 9 home runs in June and batted nearly 400. Hit 396 for the month. Jeter started out hitting 189, as his parents are here tonight. Started out at 189 through May 25th. Since then, hitting 403. But through May 25th, he had the lowest average in the majors among batting qualifiers. What a turnaround for him. And with terrific power as well. A big June behind him. And some big bruises to show for that 13-inning win over Boston. Sheffield next, then A-Rod. Traxel's 2-0 pitch. He's taking, and it's outside for ball three. Right through there, Jeter taking all the way. There's Jeter with 13 home runs now. And two of them came last weekend against Trachsel.
Derek Jeter, you can tell that that eye is still bothering him. He's getting some sort of fluid in there. Either that tear ducts are still running or the perspiration may be irritating that eye.
Well, he sees well enough to take ball four from Trachsel. Steve's first walk of the ball game, and this one begins the inning. 5-0 in the fourth. And the Yankees have their captain aboard.
We're going through, through the lineup here for the second time. Going to the 12th hitter when you get to Sheffield. In the first nine hitters, I saw two good swings off of Trachsel. The ball that Sheffield popped up in the first inning. I mean, he just missed it. He had a good pitch to hit. He missed it. The single by Posada in the second. And every other pitch, Yankees have been off balance, looking inside and Trachsel throwing away, or vice versa. What you don't want to do is open the door by walking Jeter and then get the big bombers after that coming through.
In there for a strike on Sheffield.
Looking for the pitcher's best friend right here. Double play ball.
But Trachsel knows, and Sheffield knows, I think Al Leiter even knows, that Gary Sheffield is a 396 career hitter off Trachsel with four home runs. Jeter aboard. He leads at first. Now, part of yesterday's problems that Joe Torre thought were problems anyway was Gary Sheffield was stepped out a couple of times and thought that maybe that angered some of the pitchers, and that's the reason that Gary Sheffield was drilled. At least that was part of it. Here's the 0-1 pitch. Big swing and a miss. Well, Traxel's a guy, as everyone knows, takes a long, long time to deliver the pitch.
Something off speed. And Sheffield way out in front. Way out in front. Big swing. Out of sync on that one. You wouldn't suggest that or think that Jeter's going to run at first base. He's banged up. You watch him throw in between innings. And he doesn't make any real strong throws to first base either. He's got some bumps and bruises in that body, so he's a little bit out of sync. And Trachsel spent a lot of time making sure that he's staying there at first base. You're down by five runs, or you're up by five runs. You got your big hitter at the plate. I don't think that you would run.
Foul back, a mighty cut by Sheffield. Barely nudged it over the top of the screen. Nothing into it.
One of the things we talked about in the opening is a home run. Well, what have the Yankees been doing? They've been hitting the ball out of the ballpark. They've been making their living and putting food on the table by hitting home runs.
116.
And this is a game here down by five runs. You think Joe Torre's looking to single you to death? He wants a couple of those bombers in there. Give me a two-run job and a three-run job.
Yankees with the most home runs in the big leagues. Sheffield has hit 13 of them. Jeter gets back in, never slid. Now the White Sox right on their tail as far as the home run totals. The Texas Rangers team getting a great year out of Hank Blaylock, who swings for the fences virtually every cut. And he's been connecting a lot. That's a team that can score some runs. With Young and Teixeira, they've got some guys who can swing. Runner not going, and it's outside on Sheffield. So one ball and two strikes. A-Rod, the former Ranger, in the on-deck circle.
White Sox still lead the major leagues of runs scored, 433. Yankees have scored 420. What a surprise team, huh? Big Hurts having a pretty good year. Chicago.
Yeah, they've been doing this lately without Maglio Ordonez. Once again, Jeter gets back in. And the White Sox with a two-game lead over Minnesota going into play tonight. They made the trade to get another pitcher, Freddy Garcia.
I looked in the box score today. Timo Perez, who Mets traded in spring training to the Chicago White Sox, is hitting 292, playing pretty good baseball for Ozzie Guillen, the manager over there.
It's a good offensive lineup. The 1-2 into the dirt, blocked by Piazza, and Jeter will freeze at first base. A lot of splitters again from Trachsel in this outing. Sheffield, I mean, he always looks antsy in the batter's box. But has to wait a long time for Trachsel to pitch. He steps out now. The Mets in front here, 5-0. Kaz Matsui has knocked a three-run homer out of here. That's been the key blow. Jeter takes off. Swung on and missed. Piazza's throw won't get him. But Gary Sheffield strikes out. A theft of second for Derek Jeter, who continues to fly all over the place as he goes diving to second.
On the 2-2 pitch, and we talked about Sheffield, does not strike out very much. Good fastball on the outside part of the plate. Big jump by Jeter at first. No chance to get him. And the ninth stolen base for the Yankee shortstop. Off-speed pitch, huge jump at first base.
You're right about Sheffield, just the 30th strikeout all season for him. For a guy who swings that hard.
And about 275 at-bats, too.
Rodriguez now, he's tapped back to the mound, 0-1. One man out, swinging a fly ball to center. Spencer backs up, has room to make the catch, he's got it. Jeter very aggressive, heading into third. He's there standing, two down. Shane Spencer getting that start tonight with Mike Cameron out with a balky knee as well as a bit of a groin problem, as Kip told us earlier. So two down, and here comes Hideki Matsui. It's still fairly early, only the fourth inning, but already a rough night for Hideki. Struck out looking in the second inning, made an error on the warning track early in the game. In the very first inning, he dropped the fly ball. That was off the bat of Cliff Floyd. Now he tries to pick up an RBI with Derek Jeter at third and two away. Trachsel oh so deliberate, and the first pitch in the dirt. Piazza's getting a workout. We saw Mike in between innings getting some cold towels draped over his head.
This is another off-speed pitch, breaking ball. That's curveball in the dirt. Nice job by Piazza to block it. Keep the tailgate down.
Posada would be next, but there are two gone. The 1-0 hammer to center field, but right at Spencer. Barely had the move to make the catch. Side retired. No runs or hits. A walk, a stolen base. Jeter gets to third. He's stranded there. When we come back, Jose Reyes will bat second in the inning, followed by Kaz Matsui. They have a 5-0 lead. They've out-hit the Yankees 7-1. The Yankees charged with an error as well. Three runs in the second inning. All those off the bat of Kaz Matsui. A three-run homer. Trachsel starting off the home half of the fourth here for the Mets. Put down a sacrifice bunt in the second inning. And it's Reyes and Kaz Matsui. Trachsel's handled the bat quite well this year. He's hitting right at 200. Well, a win tonight for Steve. He is 8-6. And we'll get another start before the All-Star break as well. Takes the 0-2 up high. One ball, two strikes. If the Yankees win, we're breaking up. Hey, there's a lot on the line on this one, Tom. Even more than we thought. The end of romance as we know it. Routine ground ball. Cairo with it. On to Clark for out number one. Well, this Sunday, the fireworks are starting early with the WB11's Three's Company 4th of July Marathon. Don't miss your chance to spend 7 hilarious hours with Jack, Janet, Chrissy. WB11's Three's Company 4th of July Marathon, Sunday starting at 10 a.m. right here in the WB11. Tom, I know you can't get enough. Jose Reyes is flying to right. He's also beaten out an infield hit on a dubious call at first base that certainly did go the Mets way. He takes ball one. The Mets are getting production tonight out of the top of the order. Reyes with a hit. Kaz Matsui with a 3-run homer. This one fly to right field. Pretty well hit, but Sheffield moves over toward the line. Two down. The top of the order has not been a productive spot for the New York Mets. But tonight it has been. Kaz is 1-for-2. He's grounded a short. The 3-run homer in the second inning off Mussina made it 5-0. 0-for-0 coming into tonight, the Mets had the lowest batting average, the fewest hits, and the most strikeouts in the majors. In their 1-2 spots in the order combined, Kaz trying to change it.
Kaz sitting right in the catbird seat right there with Piazza in the on-deck circle. Certainly Mike Mussina did not want to walk him and have to face Piazza with the bases loaded.
And sliced down deep into the left field corner, but foul.
And they got behind Matsui. And Kaz Matsui and just sit on that dead red and got a mediocre fastball in the middle of the plate. Turned on it very quickly. And home run number 6 for him. You could bet that his picture will be on the cover of the Yomiuri Shimbun in Tokyo next edition.
Did you just make up that name?
No, that's it. That's the big newspaper and Yomiuri Shimbun. And they own the, I think they own the Tokyo Giants. They are, yeah, unless sense. Something is happening.
I think they do. Right. They are the Yomiuri Giants. Mm-hmm. In Japan, teams are named after, not the team name, but what prefaces that is a company name. Could make refrigerators, they could sell newspapers, they could make candy bars. Swung on and foul tip to the mitt for strike 3. Posada does a nice job hanging on, and that's it for Kaz Matsui as he fans. Mussina has set down the last 6 in a row. Here comes Trachsel, right-hand corner. You've won an autographed Al Leiter jersey. See your game card for instructions on how to redeem your prize. That's the combination you're looking for. There, a home run. Go. Here's Posada now, base hit in the second inning. He is 1-for-1. Posada, Tony Clark, and Miguel Cairo, the batters. That's 6, 7, and 8. Against Trachsel, who has given up just one hit, and that's to this man, Posada. Now the fourth inning started with Jeter taking ball 4. Eventually he would steal a base, but Trachsel, working through a very tough part of the order, struck out Sheffield. It was while Jeter was stealing the base. Got A-Rod to fly out and got Matsui to line out, both of them to center field. And ball and a strike on Posada. Ball and one ball and two strikes on Posada as Derek Jeter has gone 0-for-1 tonight. Switch hitting catcher Posada. And the 1-2 pitch from Trachsel. Up the middle. Matsui gets to it, spins, throws off balance. A beautiful play to get him. Turning out to be a wonderful night for that man, Kaz Matsui.
That'll be in a highlight film somewhere. Posada does not run very well, so plenty of time for Matsui. Nice little pirouette. And a strike going forward to Eric Valen at first base. That's showing you some big league defense right there. Takes a hit away from Posada, who had singled his first time up.
Tony Clark 0 for 1. He struck out in inning number 2. Now this one seems to be going along the lines of most of the Yankees and Mets games in these Subway Series. 9 of the last 14 have been decided by a margin of 5 or more runs. The Yankees winning 6, the Mets 3. That included all 3 games last weekend in the Bronx. And the Mets have a 5-0 lead here. So the nature of this series, Tom, has been big margins for the winner and rain for both of them.
And home runs. Home runs against Trachsel, his last start against the Yankees over at the stadium. Matsui, the grand slam he had in that series. Not a good swing again by Tony Clark. I was talking about good swings, and you know, a pitching coach will sit there and watch his pitcher, and how many times the hitters have good swings. Clark, you see him collapse everything to try to get the bat out of the ball. And up to until the fourth inning, really only 2 good swings in the ball game by Sheffield and then Posada. 2 good swings last inning, one by Rodriguez and Matsui. Don Mattingly, the hitting coach.
The 1-2 to Clark. Little trickler. Gonna be a tough play. Trachsel with a bare hand, throws and gets him. Made it look pretty easy. No panic there in Trachsel to get Clark. 2 down.
And another bad swing. Trachsel pitching beautifully, keeping the hitters off balance. And you can see Clark way out in front. The hand flies off. And he hit the ball about 15 feet. Trachsel, a good athlete. Fields his position very well and barehanded. Throws the ball perfectly to Valente, the first baseman. Well, when you see a team not getting good swings, off balance, one-handed swings, trying to collapse, it means your pitcher is getting more than one pitch over. Hitters can't just sit there and look for a singular pitch. All right, I'm just going to look for breaking ball. All right, I'm just going to look for the fastball. And you can get to the point where you don't get pitches over in the right spot. Hitters will say, well, I'm just going to look for fastball middle in. I don't have to look for anything else, because this pitcher's not throwing anything for strikes on the outside part of the plate. Well, Trachsel has been, he's been very, very good tonight. His hitter's still off balance against him.
Fly, pretty well hit right field, but Hidalgo backs up, snatches it. 1-2-3 they go. Once again, that's for the 3rd time in 5 innings. 2 up. Mike Piazza, Cliff Floyd, and to purchase your Grand Slam ticket pack, show up at Shea, call 718-507-TIXX, or log on to Mets.com. Have your MasterCard ready. Dave O'Brien with Hall of Famer Tom Seaver. Mike Piazza in the box. So far tonight, he has not made an out. He has singled and drawn a walk. Started the evening hitting .312 with 16 home runs. Piazza catching this evening, batting out of the 3 slot. Rips that one sharply right up against the tarp, which was necessary earlier tonight. At 7:10, it was raining here.
Little sinker in, Mike Piazza, real good bat speed. That ball whistled down the left field line. And Alex Rodriguez looked over at the third base dugout, looking into his own dugout. Like, what happened? What did I do if he hits it at me?
Line shot, this one fair, and it drops into left field for a base hit. Mike's 2 for 2. So having a good old time against Mussina. Ripping line drives and blowing bubbles.
There's a hanging curveball right there. Piazza out in front. Ball's out and away from a little bit, but you saw it coming, read it very early. That ball gets in about 4 or 5 inches. That's a home run to left field. But Mike in line drive to left field. 8th hit for the New York Mets here tonight. Another mistake by Mussina, capitalized on by the Met offense.
Cliff Floyd has reached on an error, although he did send Matsui to the warning track where he dropped the ball in the first inning. He's also singled. Piazza not being held at first base, and it's inside for ball one. I'm talking about Mike getting the catch tonight as Hidalgo waits on deck. Mike Piazza has now started more games as a first baseman this year than as a catcher, as of Wednesday's game in Cincinnati when he started at first base for the 33rd time this season. A sweeping miss by Cliff Floyd. One ball and one strike.
Lifted that ball sharply to left field the first time up. Single a second time up. Off-speed pitch. Out in front of it a little bit. We've been swinging a hot bat of late.
Mussina usually very effective, particularly against left-handers. He'll come inside on those thumbs a lot and try and bury that fastball in on the knuckles. He has not allowed a home run to a left-hand batter in his last 10 starts. Inside there.
Another one right there, right inside.
Two balls, one strike.
Take a look at it again. You've hit it on the corner at best. If you miss, you miss in toward the hitter, and that's what Mussina does so well. When he is pitching well, he makes that plate, and then that pitch on the corner of that plate, that'll let it slide out back over the plate.
Swing and a miss. Floyd with another mighty cut. Seldom cheated on that kind of a swing, 2-2.
Little two-seam fastball, about 85 miles an hour, and right there, maybe a little bit of a nickel slider there, huh? A little downward movement on it right at the end.
Piazza getting a short lead at first. Nobody out. The 2-2. Swing and a miss. He struck him out. So Cliff Floyd is retired. One out in the fifth for the Mets. Time for Dodge trivia now. Which four players won a gold glove, then played 100 and more games at another position the following season? I think recently, didn't Craig Biggio do that? As he moved from,
I think that sounds right,
his catching position out to second base, and of course second base out to the outfield. This year he's had his problems moving around the outfield, playing for Hidalgo's old team, the Houston Astros. Richard's starting to fit in real well. He's 2-for-2 tonight. A double that drove in a run in the first inning. He's also singled. He was 5-for-12 last weekend at Yankee Stadium in his first Subway Series. That included two solo homers against Mussina. He also belted a home run and a double Thursday in Cincinnati. Hit a big series against the Reds. Hit 375 in that series. Tried to hold up. The home plate ump said he went. Mike Riley said he swung the bat. 0-2.
Tried to hold up, but he did go. Good running fastball up right at that left elbow.
The Mets trying to beat Mike Mussina for the first time ever. He is 5-0 with a 3.10 ERA against the Mets. Outside. 1-2. Shane Spencer coming up next. Hidalgo looking very, very comfortable. You can tell by that last pitch, just a hair off the corner. And he did not think about swinging the bat. But he's a pretty confident hitter right now. He asks for time.
We've seen a 9-4 on the year. And an interesting thing about a club that has a good offense, the way that the Yankees do. We talk about the number of runs that they've scored. He's won 9 games. And the Yankees have averaged 9 runs per win that he is when he has pitched.
As Matsui getting to him in the second inning with a 3-run homer. Piazza reaching moments ago with a base hit. Then Floyd struck out. The 2-2 to Hidalgo, swinging a deep drive left field. This one's gone right now. Look at this baby sail. Gone. Hidalgo strikes again. That's three home runs off of Mussina in the last two weekends. I'll tell you what, Tom Seaver, he's a different hitter than the guy the Houston Astros traded.
He's got that kind of power. When it goes and leaves the bat, you know that thing is gone. That was a monster home run to left field. Mike Mussina has always given up a lot of home runs, 21 last year, 27 the year before. And one year he gave up 31 with the Baltimore Orioles back in 96. And this, a no-doubter, out over the plate. Looked like a little spinning breaking ball. Two home runs in this ball game, one by Matsui, one by Hidalgo. And now 13 home runs that he has given up on the year.
Richard Hidalgo played 70 games with Houston. And just didn't find that home run stroke at the end. He wasn't hitting anything. Well, now he's hit five home runs in 13 games as a member of the Mets.
Here's the tail end of it. Big, long, high drive. It has that certain sound, that certain speed coming off the bat head, a certain trajectory. Mike Mussina knew it. 90% of everybody else here at Shea Stadium in a sold-out house knew it as well.
Swing and a miss by Spencer. He's down on strikes. Two gone. Let's listen to the home run by Hidalgo. He got good wood on it. So Hidalgo with four home runs in 70 games as a member of the Astros. He's already hit one more than that in just 13 games with the Mets. That is a trade that is looking better and better. Ty Wiggins at 0 for 2. He's flying to center and popped out foul to first. 7 to nothing, the Mets building a rout here of the Yankees.
And one hit for the Yankees.
A two-run homer for Hidalgo, a three-run homer for Kaz Matsui. And they are chasing Mussina. O-2 pitch, that's hammered into left, right at Hideki Matsui. The side is retired. The Mets continue to get very good swings. Hidalgo's 3 for 3. He's a triple shy of the cycle because he's added the home run. A two-run blow. The Mets on top, 7-0. All Mets here, 7-0. Mike Mussina is being taken out of this game. He has pitched his last. Bret Prinz is now warming up in the bullpen. And Kenny Lofton is going to hit for Mussina to begin the sixth inning. So the Mets, after falling twice in the three games at Yankee Stadium last weekend, have a big 7-0 lead. Dribbled on a swinging bunt. Piazza has to hustle, throws off balance, and throws it down the right field line. A wild toss. Hidalgo backing up. Dropping into second, Kenny Lofton. Piazza, an ill-advised throw. Lofton can still run pretty well. And that throwing mistake pushes him down to scoring territory.
A perfect swinging bunt for Kenny Lofton. Really no chance that Piazza had to get the runner at first base. And fired it down that left field line, excuse me, the right field line. It'll be Aaron Piazza, his 10th error of the year, trying to runner Lofton to get the second. And the 68th error of the season for the Mets defense.
A base hit and an E2. And here's Bernie Williams now. 0-for-2 in the game. The Yankee fans begin to spring to life for the first time this evening, at least since the pregame festivities. Williams has popped out to short. He's also grounded to second. Fouls it away for a strike. One of the themes of our pregame when we came on the air was Yankee come from behind victories. where it seems that no score is safe. It's 7-0 here. Trachsel pitching very well. The Yankees, however, have made their living and their best record in the majors by coming back on people. 31 come from behind wins.
And they've got a number of guys in that lineup to take the ball out of the ballpark.
Good pitch. On and
miss. Yeah, it's a great pitch by Trachsel. A lot of these bad swings by the Yankee hitters. All-time highs come from behind wins. 31 for the Yankees. Chicago White Sox under their new manager, Ozzie Guillen.
And of course, the Yankees coming off a resounding come-from-behind win against Boston in 13 innings. And an amazing baseball game. Derek Jeter wound up going to the hospital after his 12th inning fly into the stands. And he went flying into the stands. Showing the residue of that all over his face and his shoulder, other parts of his body.
We talked about, you and I talked about a little bit before the game about this series, and maybe the break, certainly the Mets get a break playing at home. That game last night at Yankee Stadium took almost 4.5 hours, 4 hours and 20 minutes to play. Joe Torre had to use 6 pitchers out of his bullpen. That has an impact on this ball game here tonight and tomorrow with a day game.
And of course, the draining nature of it being Yankees Red Sox to begin
sure,
with.
Sure, absolutely. The emotional ups and downs.
Sure. Yeah. 1-2 on Bernie Williams.
And then we've got to, you know, if you're saying we, meaning the Yankees, well, but now we got to go across town, be in New York, just the way the Mets did last year, last weekend when they had to go to Yankee Stadium. Then we're going to have 50,000 people booing us in our own hometown. I don't think it bothers them one iota, but it's one of those little psychological things that, you know, plays on one's mind.
The 1-2 fastball inside. Trachsel kind of dipping his head after drilling that one in there. Clearly yes. Wanted it.
Steve Trachsel wanted this. I looked like it might have been high when it went across the plate. Certainly caught in the right spot by Piazza. Let's see this one here. Going for that left elbow. I don't think I blame him for wanting it. It was right at the elbow. That's really the line right there. That front elbow went right by it. And it's clearly on the plate.
2-2 got him that time. He catches him looking. Bernie Williams to take a seat. Trachsel strikes him out. One away.
4-strikeout for Trachsel. And that's a good one right there. Got that moving fastball. Trying to jump out of the way. Watching Bernie Williams try to back up. Oh, I'm going to back up. Clearly on the plate. Right up at knee level.
Now Jeter, the Yankee fans in attendance, and plenty of them here at Shea, as he came up to bat for the first time in the first inning, right before he grounded out, gave him a standing ovation.
And David, you heard me talk about there's certain outs in the ball game that you've got to have, and this is one of them right here, talking about Derek Jeter. Yes, point being 7-0 ball game. This is a ball club that can score a lot of runs. Talking about the Yankees, and they can score them in bunches, and they score them with home runs. And the guy in the on-deck circle right there is what I'm talking about. Don't give him the opportunity to hit a three-run and virtually cut the lead in half.
Yank foul. That one skips off into the crowd off the bat of Jeter. 1-1. Jeter has been troubled by his right eye from time to time tonight. He's been blinking it a lot, kind of affected by the collision yesterday in the stands. You can see he's got a pretty good shiner going there. Trachsel with a set in the 1-1 pitch into the dirt. Mike Piazza has done a very effective job back there. Certainly not something Mike is ever recognized for, defensive prowess, but he's been very busy.
That's a splitter. Down in the dirt, proverbial 55 footer. Nicely played by Piazza. Just stop it, keep out in front of you.
Lofton, the runner at second. Piazza has committed an error in this inning after the base hit by Kenny Lofton, enabling him to get to scoring territory. 2-1 is off the corner. You saw Jeter take a step right into the bucket to get a good look at it. 3-1. Prinz is ready. He'll be the next Yankee pitcher. Mussina's been lifted. Lofton hit for him in this inning. 7-0 the Mets. Home runs by Kaz Matsui and Richard Hidalgo striking again. The 3-1, he's going for it, fouled it away. That was ripped into the crowd very quickly.
That's a pretty good cut right there by Derek Jeter. He's in the same situation Matsui was in earlier when he homered with Mike Piazza in the on-deck circle. That's a good swing right there. Sitting at 3-1. Down by 7 runs, you know you get fastball. One of the best swings of the game for the Yankees. Even at that, he was a tad tardy. He sat right on that heater. Put a good swing on it. Big pitch right here in this ballgame. And I say that from the standpoint, you're going to keep your opponent on the mat. Don't give him a chance to get off the mat. Now sometimes you do. They say, why in the world? Okay, why in the world would a pitcher do that? You're up 7-0. You got a runner at second base. It means absolutely nothing. Why in the world would you try and pick him off, or why would a runner get picked off? And there are sometimes a pitcher will do that to put whatever psychological edge you can get into the hitter, make him a little bit more anxious, or a burr under his saddle.
Well, if he had one, he didn't show it. Very patiently accepting ball four.
Well, we've watched Jeter, and he follows those balls into the right into the catcher's mitt. He did it on a pitch earlier. Well, base on balls that Steve Trachsel did not want. That's just his second in the ballgame.
Well, he has gotten Gary Sheffield twice tonight, and a fly to left and a strikeout. But usually, Sheffield is the last guy in the world that Trachsel wants to face. Yeah, Gary, a 396 career hitter off him coming into tonight.
The other point, David, is you don't remember the fly ball to left field missed by a fraction of being a home run to left.
Mm-hmm.
Did a great swing, hit it on the right part of the bat, just missed it. Just a little bit of the bottom half of the ball. Trachsel pitched very well the last time up to the plate, the fourth inning.
It's interesting that the 29 home runs that Sheffield has hit against the Mets, only 7 have come at Shea Stadium. There has been talk over the last several years before he went to the Yankees, leaving the Atlanta Braves, that Gary Sheffield might choose to come and play for the New York Mets. He has said he always wanted to play in New York. Somewhere. Squeezing that bat. Runners at first and second. One out. Big swing and a miss. 1-1.
Another off-speed pitch. He was fooled last time up in that at-bat. You see how the hand comes off the bat? That means you're way out in front. He's strong enough to hit it out of here one-handed, but clearly way out in front. And it's the second time in 2 at-bats that Trachsel is completely fooled Sheffield with off-speed pitches.
The Trachsel has not gotten in front of many hitters tonight, strike one, but he's had a very good splitter going. Sheffield again winding up and an 85 mile an hour fastball.
Well, he missed the fastball. Looked like it was right down Broadway. Nope, it's off-speed pitch. It looked like he hurt something right there. Winced something in his back. That looks like back. He really lets this swing go. His shoulder has been bothering him. That, yeah, maybe his shoulder, but certainly looked like he may have twisted that lower back.
How could you not hurt something swinging like that? And sharply but foul. As a human being, how can you swing that hard and twist your body up with that kind of torque and not injure yourself on every swing? Sheffield remarkably strong, 0-2 tonight. 86 pitches for Trachsel. First pitch strikes, though, just 6 out of 21 hitters. So he's been successful tossing right now 2-hit shutout without throwing strike one. Now Sheffield will ask for time. Runners at first and second. 7-0 the Mets. We are in the top half of the sixth inning at Shea. Hard hit. Oh, right through Wigginton. Down the line, here comes Lofton in. Jeter into third, and into second, standing up, Gary Sheffield. He pulled it right underneath the third baseman, Ty Wigginton.
That ball hit like a rocket, but a ball should have been played by Wigginton. Gets back on his heels a little bit. Tricky hop. And a break for the New York Yankees.
Well, in the first inning, it was the Yankees who were sloppy in the field. Here in the sixth inning, Art Howe's Mets are sloppy in the field, committing their second error in this frame. Remember, Piazza on his wild throw was charged with one.
And David, one of the things that we've talked about it before, about the pace of the ball game, sometimes that Trachsel will set. If you're quick on the mound, get the ball, take care of business, and deliver it to home plate, you get better defense played behind you. You don't get infielders that get back on their heels. Take a look at this last pitch. Sinker down, two hops right to Wigginton and right through the wicket for his 12th error of the year. And the Mets with two tonight and now 69, but that is clearly double play ball. And see what I'm talking about, back on his heels. The game is it's a game of timing and rhythm and tempo. And Minton get on the base against Trachsel, and he takes all the tempo out of the ballgame.
So here's Alex Rodriguez with runners at second and third. Jeter and Sheffield out there. Rodriguez has driven in 48 runs for the Mets, not for the Yankees. One man out, runners at second and third, and the pitch is inside for ball one. A-Rod just 2-for-17 off of Steve Trachsel. The on-deck hitter, Hideki Matsui. There's just no let-up in this lineup. Big swing and a miss. 1-1.
Oh, he had a good pitch to hit right there. Right now in Broadway, right now in the middle of the plate. Steve got away with a pitch there.
The 1-1, high fly ball, right field deep. Hidalgo at the edge of the track. He's got it. Jeter tags up. In he comes, that run. I think you can really go back and charge to Ty Wigginton. A-Rod drives in his 49th on the sacrifice. It is 7-2.
Got a fastball up and out over the plate. Pitched a drive right there. Did not get it all. Makes you wonder if that ball had been out of Yankee Stadium. Probably not. Too far down or too far to the right of straightaway right field. Interesting thing about playing in different ballparks. Nonetheless, the Mets hopefully can get out of this inning with just giving up a couple of runs.
Matsui 0-for-2. He's been called out on strikes and also lined out to center. Sheffield the runner at third. And what a huge psychological difference it is, Tom, allowing just the two runs to score as opposed to allowing Sheffield to score here, make it 7-3.
There's no question. I mean, the worst case scenario, obviously, is Matsui, the other home run threat in the middle of that lineup, hitting the ball out of the ballpark. But he is 0-for-7 lifetime against Trachsel.
Fastball too high, 1-1.
The thing about, you know, and I talk about, you know, there's how many big outs are there in the ballgame you have to have, you know, five. Put your finger on five or six outs. The thing is, when you got a ball club like the Yankees, and you've got a string of guys, all of them hit the ball out of the ballpark,
all of a sudden it's more than just five outs in the ball game. And this is a perfect example, because all of a sudden you went from Sheffield to Rodriguez to Matsui. Three guys can hit the ball out of the ballpark in a heartbeat.
Inside almost hit him.
And it's more of an emotional switch than anything else. Good pitch right there by Trachsel. I mean, the home run, if the Yankees can put a couple more runs on the board, where does the emotion swing to? Now, instead of the Mets being on the easy street, they're trying to hold the Invaders off. Put Rick Peterson on the phone to that bullpen.
Well, someone's going to start getting warmed up out there in a hurry. The 2-1 pitch. Ground ball right at Reyes. And the side is retired. The Yankees do pick up a couple because the Mets make two errors in the inning. Prinz coming on. It is 7-2 now. He just got a base hit and a pinch hit capacity. And Bret Prinz comes out of the bullpen for Joe Torre's team. Made his 13th appearance of the season in Wednesday's win against Boston. And he walked the only man he faced in the seventh inning. So Trachsel putting on the gloves. He is scheduled to hit right after Eric Valente, who will lead off the inning. Mike Mussina only lasted for 74 pitches tonight. So he wound up going five innings. There's something up with Posada, the Yankee catcher. We were just about to get this half inning underway, and he went down at a crouch outside the batting circle, and the trainer is over to examine him. And now he's up and he says, come on, let's go to Prinz.
Okay, with something on the left hand, huh? See that out of the back of his glove, his catcher's glove on the thumb. There's a piece of plastic coming out of there, and that prevents the thumb from being hyperextended toward the back of the wrist, going toward the wrist. He catches that ball in the thumb, and it pushes that. That's the ball there, and it pushes the thumb back. Thumb protector.
He's had a little bit of injury trouble this year. Missed four games with a broken nose back in May, but it's a long way from the thumb. Valente is 1-for-2 tonight with a base hit as he files that one away. 7-2, the Mets in front here in the sixth inning. Now here it is, in between innings as Prinz was warming up. That one went off the glove. And then Posada a little bit shaken up apparently on that warm-up toss. In there for strike in the inside corner, and Valente strikes out. One away in the sixth inning. Time for trivia. We'll give you the answer as well. You've had time to think about this and discuss it with your friends. Which four players won a gold glove, then played 100-plus games in another position the following season? And here are the answers. With George Scott going to third base. Big George. Schmidt going to first base. After all those years, is, for my money, the best third baseman who ever lived. Who's the best third baseman you ever seen?
We have to argue your pick, big boy. All the way around. Brooks Robinson was an incredible player, but Mike Schmidt bought the element of power big time to third base.
You should say so.
You know, and mostly I don't lose if I pick Eddie Matthews. You know, who was a great player on that Braves team at 56, 57, whatever it was, 57, 58. Braves have beat the Yankees, and I think it was 57, and Henry Aaron and Billy Bruton and Adcock and Eddie Matthews.
So you don't lose with Eddie, but you're not being invited back to the Schmidt family barbecue anytime soon. So you lose there.
Well, you know, the wine list was mediocre anyway. So.
But you love those little pickles, didn't you?
Oh, God. The homemade, too.
Schmidt, he's a very talented guy.
Sweet and dill. You know, whichever way you want. You know.
Wonderful spread they had there. The 2-2 outside on Trachsel.
Are you going this year?
I'm in.
You're invited. Of course you are.
I'm saying now.
Yeah, Posada. He may have those two fingers taped together. No, he doesn't. There's that brace on that thumb brace that keeps that thumb from being hyperextended, if that's the right term. Stretching those ligaments out.
Trachsel 0-for-1. He almost shook up the Yankees big time there. A-Rod playing way off the line. He lines that one to the middle and a clean base hit by the diving Jeter. So in the end, he does break them up. A one-out single for Steve Trachsel.
Well, we've seen Steve Trachsel make a good fielding play. We're talking about being a good athlete. Good swing right there. He is one for two tonight with a sacrifice bunt. Came in hitting 200. Well, if you're a pitcher, you can help yourself with a 200 average once in a while through the course of a season. Get a key base hit once in a while. You really help your ball club.
Reyes going after the first pitch, fouls it back. Jose is one for three with an infield single tonight. He hit a home run yesterday in Cincinnati. The Mets homered four times. Kaz Matsui has homered tonight. A three-run blow, as has Richard Hidalgo, a two-run shot. 0-2 on Reyes. 55,068 here at Shea Stadium this evening. That is a sellout. They had to wait through a 42-minute rain delay before we could get going. He bids for pitch in the dirt, strikes out. That's good morning, good afternoon, good night.
And a bad at-bat right there for Jose Reyes. This is way out of the strike zone. I mean, that's not even on the same block. That's down the street about three blocks away, that one. Totally confused. You know, you're talking about how long it's going to take for him to... You know, I picked up the paper. David O'Brien was talking to me earlier about, well, how long is it going to take Reyes to get there? You know, who knows? When I picked up the paper about the home run that he hit in Cincinnati, I went, oh, no. You don't want him to hit home runs. You want him to make contact, put the ball in play, and it's almost as if a home run is a mistake. Fine defensive play, our accurate defensive gem of the ball game right here by Kaz Matsui. Brought to you by your Acura dealers.
Kaz has also added a three-run homer. That was in the second inning when Mike Mussina was still out there. Mussina only lasting five innings. Posada out to consult with Prinz here. Two down, but a 2-0 pitch to Matsui. With Trachsel aboard, the Mets with a five-run lead. He jumps back. The pitch in tight, 3-0. Couple of finals from earlier today. The Cubs beat the White Sox 6-2 in the Battle of Chicago. Montreal defeated Toronto 2-0. On the corner for strike. The Phillies and the Orioles were in a 6-6 tie in the seventh inning. Philadelphia now leading the National League East. They have a one-game advantage on the Marlins, three over the Mets. 3-2 now on Kaz Matsui. In the eighth inning, Cleveland is pouring it on Cincinnati, 15-2. Boston and Atlanta are tied up 2-2 in the ninth inning. Boy, another close one the Red Sox are involved in. Like, that's all they need. There's another drive. Sucked to right. Sailing and gone. A two-home run night for Kaz Matsui. He has driven in five runs in this game against the Yankees. He's doing his Godzilla tonight on Joe Torre's team. Two homers, a two-run shot, and a three-run blast. Really a big night for Kaz. He's also made a terrific defensive play. The fans want him. To the Mets. Mike Piazza has had a good night going too. Two singles and a walk. Richard Hidalgo is three for three. He's hit a home run. Number two tonight for Kaz.
Kaz got another fastball, middle in, boy, and a no-doubter. Line shot out of here. Home run number 7 for him. And this is a guy who got some power. People might forget it. Matsui last year hit 33 home runs in the Japanese League and 36 the year before. So he's got plenty of pop in his bat.
No swing for Mike Piazza.
I think I'd take Mike Piazza out to dinner if I'm Kaz Matsui. I might really buy you a nice steak here tonight.
Well, hitting right in front of Mike Piazza when the count gets to 1-0, 2-0, 3-1. There aren't too many better places to be, especially when Mike's having a big offensive year. He's having a very good one. Here's the 3-2 pitch. Socked into right, coming on Sheffield. He'll make the catch. That's it. But Kaz Matsui, with his second home run of the ballgame, has driven in 5 runs this evening, powering the Mets to a 9-2 lead. Game card time to announce our first Lincoln Mercury and Delta Airlines instant winner. If your game card has the number 118959 in the right-hand corner, you have won an autographed Jose Reyes jersey. See your game card for instructions on how to redeem your prize. Now, if your game card matches the win the innings 3-in-a-row combination on your screen, you've just won a Mets bobblehead. See game card for instructions on how to redeem your prize. And glad we could help. Posada leading off the 7th inning. It's just the way the Subway Series goes. It's haymaker after haymaker for one side. And laughers. And tonight it's the Mets' turn, at least so far, 9-2 over the Yankees. Softly hit right to the feet of Reyes. One up, one down for Steve Trachsel. Tony Clark on his way up next. Well, the news at 10 is coming your way following the game. Stay right here on the WB11. We have had a 42-minute rain delay, so the news will be a little later than normal. This game starting at 7:50 or so tonight. 7:52. Tony Clark, since the game got started, has not done much. He is 0-for-2 at the plate, a strikeout and a ground ball back to the hill.
It was nice fireworks, too, for the Mets to have for us tonight before the ball game. It was like
Mr. Met was running for cover because it was not the fireworks, it was lightning.
Man, was that some show we had out there toward the Triboro Bridge.
As a player, when you saw that lightning flash like that, you just 3 seconds, you're in the clubhouse?
Red flag, baby. If you want to call me, I'll be indoors someplace.
You were out in the wide open space.
Yes, sir.
I didn't see anybody walking, that's for sure. It was a pretty serious lightning display. They said it would clear, and it did. Here's the 1-1. Here's a look before the game. This is just as the rain was beginning to fall. They had not even completely tarped the field yet. Lightning strikes. Now it's so much more calm. On the corner for strike. 2-2. Miguel Cairo next up. Over 55,000 in the house of Che. Matsui hoovers this up. Right on the money. Two down. I wonder if Trachsel will say at the end of the night, once the game is over, if he pulls out the victory, which would put Steve at 8-6, that this was maybe his best splitter, or certainly one of the best splitters that he has had all season long. Now, being on the mound at Shea Stadium brings out the best in him. A 1.76 ERA pitching at home this year. That is the second best home ERA in the National League. He hasn't thrown many first pitch strikes, so it's unusual that he'd be this successful. He's throwing a two hitter
with two runs in, and both of those runs are unearned that the Yankees scored in the 6th inning. And I think it's more than just the splitter too, Dave. I mean, it's when you're pitching this well against a ball club that is so offensively potent as the Yankees are, you've got more than one pitch that's working. His fastball has been established inside and up above the top of the strike zone. And he's changed speeds beautifully here tonight. It's very nice, very good game called by Piazza behind on play. Changing speeds because there just have not been that many comfortable-looking swings by the Yankee offense. We've seen a lot of off-speed, you know, off-balance swings. Yankee bullpen, Paul Quantrill warming up. We just haven't seen a real comfortable Yankee lineup picking their hacks at Steve Trachsel. I mean, how many comfortable swings did we see the Met offense going against Mussina? Dozens.
Yeah, there were quite a few last week, too, even though Mussina got the win in the second end of the doubleheader. Both bullpens are active. Ricky Vitalico going for the Mets. 9-2, the Mets with a big lead. Ground ball up the middle. And so he can't reach this one. Cairo is on with a two-out single.
Well, you're looking for a guy to have a terrific night. Matsui with a couple of home runs. A couple of fine defensive plays up the middle, and you think he's going to get to this one. Well, get yourself on the cover of every newspaper in New York and in Tokyo, but just could not quite get there. Ranging to his left. Not only the third hit off of Trachsel.
Kenny Lofton is one for one. He reached on an infield single, then went to second on Mike Piazza's throwing error. In that sixth inning when he got on base, the Mets made two errors, the other by Ty Wigginton on a Gary Sheffield ground ball that was through the wicket. One hit pretty sharply, but Reyes with the stop, throws on, gets him, side retired. No runs, one hit, one man left. The fans here, Shea, about to stand and stretch. 9-2 the Mets. Bottom of the seventh inning, Cliff Floyd in the box and backs away from pitch number one. A little handshake from Rick Peterson for Steve Trachsel and a job well done. Activity still in the Met bullpen. As Trachsel has gone seven, he has allowed three hits and two runs.
107 pitches. And 64 of those strikes. Johnny Franco explaining the lineup, who's going to be coming up for the Yankees next inning. John has double duty down there, left-handed reliever and quasi-pitching coach, I guess would be the title that you would give him.
He's got Paro warming up down there.
Yep, certainly got enough experience.
Cliff Floyd tonight is one for three with a single back in the second.
Couldn't have a better guy than Franco down there talking to all the young pitchers, etc. I wonder who's second in command when John comes in, then who becomes the pitching coach.
I think it goes back to Peterson. Then he gets it back. Cliff with one of the home runs yesterday in Cincinnati. Swings and fouls that one away. Over the previous four games, just before tonight now, the Mets had scored 20 runs, 16 of them on home runs. And they've hit three more home runs tonight. In support of Trachsel, swinging a deep drive, right field, way, way up there. Man, did he hit it a ton, but foul. Mercy.
Cliff Floyd never left the batter's box. You know, he got around on it too quickly, and the ball clearly fouled. That does not mean he didn't watch it. Oh, boy, I'm going to watch that baby. I don't blame him.
Into the dirt for ball four, so he reaches for the third time. He's reached on an error, singled, and walked tonight as we check out the Toyota out-of-town scoreboard. The Cubs with a win. Zambrano is now 9-3. Montreal shuts out Toronto. Levon Hernandez with a four-hit shutout in that one. Baltimore and the Phillies in a 6-6 tie. It's been all Indians against Cincinnati. Detroit leading Colorado 4-3. Look, Pudge Rodriguez having a great year, hitting in the 370s for the Tigers. Hidalgo stings this one. One hopper. Jeter flips to second for one, and the double play turned. So two down here in the Mets seventh inning as Hidalgo makes an out. In fact, two with one swing for the first time tonight. He had been 3-for-3 with a double, a single, and a homer.
You know, he got the All-Star game coming around in just, what is it, 10 days, couple weeks? Who are you going to pick from the Montreal Expos? Yeah, somebody's got to go. You got to have a representative from every team, right? For me, you just named him.
LeVon Hernandez.
Yeah. He has lost, you know, when they went through the first 6 weeks, 7 weeks of the season, I mean, the Expos would go 15 days and scored no more than two runs.
But to say, it really has to be a pitcher from that team.
Yeah.
It can't be a guy who swings a bat.
Because they just, I mean, for a while, they were averaging at best two runs. They just couldn't put points on the board at all.
Yeah, the Expos hitting .238 as a team, dead last in the big leagues.
And Hernandez has pitched very well. The one loss certainly is not going to be representative of that, but he has pitched well on that ball club. And you know what else he does? He eats up innings for you.
Well, in fact, he's pitched more innings than anybody in the National
League. Yes, sir.
And that was coming into tonight before the shutout. Little pop-up left center. Jeter turns tail, racing hard. It's going to drop in between Jeter, Lofton, and Matsui, and it's a base hit for Shane Spencer, the former Yankee, with his first hit of the game. That comes with two down.
Well, right in the Bermuda Triangle right there. That will be a line drive in tomorrow's box score. Jeter said, help. Lofton yelling, help. Matsui yelling, help. Placed perfectly by Shane Spencer.
Wigginton is 0-for-3 this evening, and he's committed an error. He takes a strike. Remember when Shane Spencer came up in late 1998 with the Yankees? Came up with a bang. He hit 8 home runs in September that year, including 3 grand slams in the final month. This one ripped toward the alley, and it's going to be up against the base of the fence for a hit for Wigginton. Spencer rounding third. No throw to the plate. He slides in safely. And the Mets are into double figures tonight against the Yankees. Ty Wigginton picking up his 30th RBI of the year.
Up and out over the plate, and he goes that way with power to right center. One hop off the wall, right off the base of the wall. And with a couple of outs, Spencer off of the races, scores easily. And double digits for the Yankees. For Wigginton, his 16th double, 30th RBI of the season. To make him feel a little bit better, making up for that error earlier in the ballgame.
So the Mets now with 10 to the Yankees 2. And every Met has at least one hit. Kaz Matsui is at 2 home runs. Mike Piazza, 2 hits. Richard Hidalgo has 3 hits and a homer. Plenty of offense to go around. A total of 13 Met hits. And now another man in scoring position where the Mets have done very well. They are 4-for-5 tonight in these spots. Now Spencer is chased in by the Ty Wigginton double. Eric Valence swings. High fly ball. Left field deep. Matsui back. Track against the wall. Leaps and can't get it. That bounces back toward the infield. Wigginton is in. Valente heading into third. He is there standing up. A 3 base hit for Eric Valente. His second hit. And it's 11-2. All this happening with 2 out. That was after the double play Hidalgo hit into. Single, double, triple.
Little man with a good power the opposite way. He's going that way. That's why he hit it off the wall. If he tries to pull that ball, it's a fly ball to right field. And in the new ballpark, Hideki Matsui having trouble in left field. Did not get back to the fence. And doesn't have the benefit of local knowledge. And with 2 outs, Wigginton scores easily. And Lux Valent, he says, I'm smelling triple. The ball got away from Matsui. I'm smelling 3, so his first triple of the year. And gets his 18th RBI. First triple of his career, by the way.
Eric 2-for-4 tonight. That brings in Wigginton, who had doubled. Met fans are loving this one tonight at Shea. 11-2 over the Yankees. Todd Zeal pinch hitting, tried to hold up, could not. That's strike one. He's hitting 244, six homers, 22 runs batted in. The 0-1 pitch popped up back of the screen and off into the seats. Kevin James, we talked to him earlier tonight, huge Met fan. And a big fan of Todd Zeal's. In fact, they're buddies. Todd, of course, was going to be dabbling in acting, wants to acting and producing when his baseball career is over. He's been doing it here in the last year or two of his career with his own production company. Two balls, two strikes. Kevin talking earlier tonight when we had him on, he was talking about Tom Seaver with the dirt on the knee. He goes all the way back to those golden days. Foul tap to the plate.
Can I ask you a question?
Go ahead.
Well, you know this is going to be kind of have a sharp edge to it. What do you mean going way back to the days?
Way back.
What are you talking ice ages?
To those.
Or what are you talking
to
about?
To those
here?
Halcyon days. A young 41. Kevin James saw a lot of those games file away.
Back to the days it is. Back to the days. When were you born, by the way? May I ask you when you were born?
1963. A great, great year in American history.
So you were around in 1969.
Sure.
You were not just hopeful.
Oh, no. Oh, I was a bright-eyed six-year-old.
And what are your remembrances of the New York Mets World Championship?
We'll get to that during the commercial break. Swung on and missed. His are much, much brighter, I think. Because I think he was there. Zeal remains in the ball game, and he's going to take over first base for Eric Valence. And Jose Parra coming out of the bullpen where he's been oh so effective in six games, a 1.59 ERA. Very impressive since being called up from the Tides. Enrique Wilson will come off the bench. He's going to hit for Bernie Williams at the very top of the order for the Yankees. It is 11-2 the Mets. With a commanding lead. They've scored in all but two innings tonight. And the Mets doing it a lot with two outs throughout the game. In fact, that's been a theme as it's filed away by Wilson. The Mets getting two in the first inning, three in the second on a Kay Matsui homer. Two in the fifth, two in the sixth, and two more in the seventh. Kaz has driven in five runs. And Richard Hidalgo has also homered. Swing, fly ball, center field. Spencer on the run, backs up, he's there. Mike Cameron nursing a tender knee and a bit of a groin injury as well. We found out right before game time. Paul Quantrill continues to loosen for the Yankees. And now Bubba Crosby is going to be announced as a hitter. He will hit for Derek Jeter.
We talked earlier, David, about 13 innings the Yankees played last night at Yankee Stadium. 11-2 ball game. Yankees put up three hits on the board. Joe Torre giving him a rest. He said, throwing in the towel, said, yep, I think this game is over. And one of the things that has to happen now, the Yankees, I mean, the Mets in that first Yankee game, the series over at Yankee Stadium. Al Leiter had a great game on Saturday. Take a look at that pitch again. The bat let go by the hitter. And they beat the Yankees and clubbed it pretty good, 9-3. First game of the series, and then came back and gave up 19 runs the next two games and a split doubleheader on Sunday. So Matt Gittner, Jaso, somebody's got to step up tomorrow and make sure that that doesn't happen tomorrow. Or Sunday here against them. Don't let him back up off the mat. Art Howe has saved his staff. Lyle Leiter and Tom Glavine are going to pitch against guys, but teams in their division.
Yeah, starting on Monday against Philadelphia, it'll be Glavine and then Tuesday Al Leiter. The first two games against the first place team in the division. The Yankees will not see them in this series. Swung on and missed, and Crosby strikes out. Two gone.
Good high fastball right there, just about letter high. Crosby way late on it. Watch this ball get by him. Ooh, the bat hit not even to the plate. Talk about a lively arm.
Ruben Sierra now. So the Yankees use pinch batters in the first three spots of the order in one inning.
One thing it does too, I mean, with Joe Torre's getting his, you know, he's getting Williams out, Jeter out, Sheffield out, and he's also getting that bat for somebody. You know, gonna get Crosby up there, get him in that bat, get Ruben Sierra in that bat. He may not, you know, guess the guy that's throwing 95 plus in the fastball. They might be going to Joe Torre, say thanks for the favor, Joe. You know, it's 10:30 at night. You get to bed till 3 a.m. And I gotta face this heater, you know. Got any other favors you want to send my way?
But you know, Bernie Williams and Derek Jeter and Gary Sheffield aren't complaining.
They're in there having a shower right now. Going, okay, well, we're going to be back here tomorrow about 1:20.
Well, one thing we will find out is the Red Sox have gone to extra innings again against Atlanta, 2-2 tie. We'll find out tomorrow what the Mets learned when facing Jose Contreras last weekend when he struck out 10. The bat splits, a little flare to center, drops down for base hit. Ruben Sierra coming off the bench. He's got himself a single. And a lot of busted bats flying all over the place. And very sharp shards of wood in all directions. Like never before.
That bat just absolutely disintegrated. Hit right on the end. Look at this. Like a spear in his hand when he gets done swinging.
Well, A-Rod stays in. He is 0 for 2, but with an RBI and a sacrifice. On a fly ball in the sixth inning. He's hit at 281. Alex Rodriguez calling that game, the 13-inning classic against the Red Sox yesterday, the best game he's ever played in or watched or been in the ballpark for in his career. One ball, one strike. He was the first guy to get to Jeter when Jeter went flying into the stands in the 12th inning.
Off-speed pitch way out in front. He was following Jeter over there, and there was one great picture in the newspaper where you could see that he had his shoulders hunched up talking about Rodriguez in fright, really afraid that Jeter was hurt. Great photograph.
Jeter would be taken off to the hospital. All the x-rays were negative, but you see the damage right on his face.
Well, the thing about Rodriguez that a lot of people don't realize is how durable he is and how many games he plays in. Just does not miss games. You go back the last 3 years. Here's that play, talking about last night's play. And there's Avery. Let's see, Avery, that was the shot right there going, oh no, I hope he's not hurt. I don't blame him. And games play, talk about durability. Jeter's very much the same way. A-Rod last year, 161 games. 2 years before that, played in every ball. And the year before that, played 148. And so he puts that uniform on and gets between the lines.
Well, you know, the average fan at home who doesn't make $25 million a year is going to say, you know what, Tom? He ought to.
I agree, totally. But there's some guys that make that money don't want to. That's my point. Regardless of what you make. You have guys that make a whole bunch of money don't want to get on the field. You know, they want to, 135 is about it. 135 can get you.
Guys like Juan Gonzalez.
He doesn't want to come out. He doesn't want to come out of the ballgame.
3 balls, 2 strikes, runner at first base, not being held. A big Met lead, 11-2. The runner goes, and it's inside for ball four. So Rodriguez takes his walk. And Hideki Matsui, another Yankee who will remain in the game, will swing here.
And we're talking about before, talking about games played, etc. And the point we made, it was last weekend, talking about Matsui, talking about, well, both Matsuis, Messiers, Matsui here in the ballpark, one for each ball club, about the games that they play. And when you're in Japan, you play every game. Sadaharu Oh was a great home run hitter. He played in every inning of every game, spring training till the end of the season, every inning of every game, because that is what is expected.
2 on and 2 out. Swung on and missed for strike. And of course, when Sadaharu Oh was the home run champion in Japan, as Matsui certainly had home run on his mind here. That was about, what, 135 games?
About 135, 140, something like that, but every inning of every game. And the point you make, you know, that you so wisely make about, well, he makes $25 million out of play. He said, people come to the ballpark to see me play. I must play. It is an obligation that I have. Fastball right by Matsui. I mean, right by him.
He is 0 for 3 this evening. He's also committed an error. The Mets' Matsui has outshone him by a lot tonight with 2 homers and 5 RBIs and a dazzling defensive play as well. We have not seen a lot of razzle-dazzle from Kaz Matsui defensively, shortstop, this year. But he made a wonderful play tonight up the middle on a spinning throw to first base. The 0-2, he would not chase it. 11 runs on 14 hits for the Mets. 2 runs on just 4 hits for the Yankees. Steve Trachsel stands to pick up the win. He's just been dynamite at home. And Steve will improve to 8-6 with the victory. And for the first time, the Mets will beat Mike Mussina if this lead holds up. 1-2 pitch is again off the corner, 2-2. This would also be the end of the Yankees' 5-game winning streak. Rick Peterson's staff ERA at 3.72. It would appear that this relationship is going to last. They're going to be safe.
I think he's negotiating. He's going to get a negotiated settlement out of this.
2-2 check swing. It's inside. The appeal. Eric Cooper says he did not offer. 3-2.
Did it hit the inside of the plate? No, inside. It did hold up at that hit. Didn't even get the home plate.
Barra needs to tighten up his control of the strike zone. Like he tightened up that spike. He's walked the man. Now he's gone to 3-2. On Hideki Matsui. Sierra and A-Rod on the bases. They get a head start on the 3-2 pitch, and it's fouled away.
You know, you're talking about guys that make a lot of money. And Parra on the mound here for the Mets. Signed with the Dodgers. You want to know where he's been in his career? Sneak this in before the next pitch. Great Falls, that's in Idaho, Bakersfield in California, San Antonio, Albuquerque, L.A., Minnesota, Salt Lake, and then Samsung Korea, Yomiuri Giants, back to Nashville, Pittsburgh. Then he went to Mexico for 2 more years. And back to Tucson and then Colorado in the Mexican League.
Well, tonight he's in New York City striking out Hideki Matsui. Number of changes here. Enrique Wilson is the new shortstop. Ruben Sierra takes over in left field for the Yankees. Bubba Crosby in right. And on the mound is the veteran Paul Quantrill. Jose Reyes is trying to pick up his second hit. As you look at the numbers on Quantrill, a 3.28 ERA.
Joe Torre used 6 pitchers in the ballgame yesterday and has got to manage his pitching staff. He got a day game here tomorrow. That's one thing that he relies on Mel Stottlemyre. Take a look at the GM turning point here in this ballgame. And pretty obvious. The first run by Kaz Matsui in the second inning, and then a no-doubter in the sixth. That second one of 3 RBIs in that ball game, and yeah, I got it all right there. Our GM turning point of the ball game. 2 home runs by number two hitter in the Met lineup tonight. They have counted 14 hits and 11 runs against the Yankees here in game one of this three-game series.
The Mets had not scored in the first inning in 14 games. They got two right away in the first inning tonight. There's been talk about the top two spots in the Mets batting order being so unproductive, but tonight Jose Reyes has one hit. Kaz Matsui has two home runs. Little flare foul. That one ran in on the bat. One ball, two strikes. Piazza next. Mike has two hits. Richard Hidalgo has three. Eric Valente has two. He fights it off, one and two.
You go back to the second inning, you're talking about production, well, throughout the lineup, and Piazza, the other's two hits, and walk, he's been on three times, had a walk in that inning. Mike Mussina faced eight hitters in the third, in the second inning. You've got three runs. Oh, they're gonna never get him. Will they get him with that speed? What a play. Wow, wow, wow. Matsui can fly down that line. And how do they get him? That is some play by Alex Rodriguez at third. Look at this. Get it? Strong arm. Yeah, you got to have a strong arm, but not that kind of throw if you're a shortstop. That's an excellent play right there. And robs a base hit away from Kaz Matsui. He can smell it. Get going down that line. Use that speed. And it takes a superior defensive play to get him at first. But indicative of the night, going back to the second inning. Ooh, I'll take it. Yeah, that's as fun as a home run right there.
So it's all new to him.
Yeah.
That position.
Yeah,
you know?
That's fun for it. Going back to that second inning, and Mussina faced only eight hitters, or faced eight hitters, and only got two outs in that inning. Five hits and a walk. Third out came, got a, Cliff Floyd ran in third, second base, and they picked him off. Or not, they threw behind him, pick him off. They threw behind him and got the third out there. Face eight hitters, only got two hits himself. So he was not very sharp tonight.
Piazza two for three, two singles, two runs. He's bolstered the average to 315. And talking about Alex Rodriguez making a play like that, he made a number of dazzling plays in their win over the Red Sox just yesterday. Won the last two Gold Gloves at shortstop in the American League, switching positions and looking so fluid over there. And plenty of time to get Piazza. Came into the night with the second highest fielding percentage. The Mets with a huge lead, 11-2 over the Yankees. Changes include Jason Phillips at catcher as we go to the ninth inning. Shane Spencer moves from center field over to left. Joe McEwing is now patrolling center. And Orber Moreno is the new pitcher. No need tonight for Braden Looper, who has had a terrific season, a 2.01 ERA and 15 saves. He's certainly going to merit, as he should, all-star consideration. There's so many guys having big years as closers. But a win tonight for the New York Mets gets them back to 500. And Braden Looper has been a major part of that. It's proven to be a terrific acquisition. Posada one for three with a single in the second inning. He tried to check in. He did on a pitch down and in. So Posada going all the way here tonight. Although Joe Torre has made a number of changes. He's taken Bernie Williams out there, Jeter out there, Sheffield. And of course Mike Mussina got knocked around tonight. He was gone early after just five innings, giving up seven runs. And even though he beat the Mets last weekend in the Bronx in game two of that doubleheader, the Mets had some very good swings off him and got five runs against him in six innings, including three homers. So it kind of started then.
Started then, but he had a nice little cushion when he went out there.
Yeah, he did. Yeah, the other night he did. Tonight, the Mets got two against him in the first, three in the second. And it was the Mets who had the cushion.
And now they've got no cheapies from the Mets either, too. They hit the ball very hard off Mussina.
This doesn't happen every day. Reyes fields, throws, and gets him. Posada, one for four. A man out in the ninth. 11 runs, 14 hits for the Mets.
Right at him. Hit sharply, but right at the second baseman Reyes. I gotcha.
Tony Clark 0 for 3, a strikeout, a ground ball to the pitcher, and a tapper to short. Steve Trachsel 2 outs away from picking up another victory, which would make him 8-6. And both of those runs charged to Trachsel, they were both unearned, were they not?
That is correct.
High top on the infield. Charging Zeal, bobbles, flip, and got him. Reyes recovered. Zeal and Reyes, as well as the play at first base, they both got the glove on it. And Reynolds would have beat it over there.
Well, you've heard of the hidden ball trick in baseball, and this is it. Zeal says, I got it. To the runner, no, I don't got it. And all of a sudden, guess who's right there? And a little flip. Good play by Marino to get there, and a terrific play by Jose Reyes, and something he does on the field, just it just doesn't seem to surprise you. It's such a natural instinct with the flair of youth, and he does so many wonderful things. Once he gets that bat rolling, he's going to be dynamite. He'll be one of those guys going to that All-Star game midseason.
So two down, and here's Miguel Cairo. The base is clean as he looks one inside. One ball, one strike. 11-2 the Mets. It has been the way of this Subway Series, certainly here in 2004. The winning team wins big. And tonight, with Giambi unavailable because of that intestinal parasite problem, it's the Mets swinging the big bats with 14 hits. Fouled off by Cairo. The Yankees have been held to 4. And it's strike 3. The ball game is over. 1-2-3 go the Yankees in the ninth. And Art Howe's New York Mets win this one in a big way. 11-2 the final score. A terrific night for Kaz Matsui as he hits a pair of home runs, a 3-run shot, a 2-run homer, and drives in 5. Richard Hidalgo had 3 hits.
3 home runs in the ballgame for the Mets, 2 by Matsui, and one of those hits by Hidalgo, the home run that came in the 5th inning. And production up and down the lineup. Even Steve Trachsel got a base hit later, scored a ball, scored a run. There's some sort of language going on here. And they, those two celebrated after the second home run by Matsui, too. They've got some sort of sign language. Nice win for the Mets here tonight at Shea.
Yep, in any language, 11-2 the final. We'll be back to start wrapping it up in a moment. Summary, 11-2, the Mets win this one going away, out hitting the Yankees 14-4. Hidalgo 3-for-4 with a home run, number 9. For the last 10 games, he's hit 5 of them for the Mets. Kaz Matsui busting out with 5 RBIs, a career high, 2 home runs for him. The Mets with 14 big flies in their last 5 games, and Trachsel pitching so well here at home, gives up no earned runs in 7 innings. Kaz all smiles, as are the Mets. They pound on the Yankees tonight, 11-2.